Hello everybody and welcome back to another video. Now in today's video we're going to be taking a look at a pretty cool little piece of software for Windows XP, and there's also a version for Windows Vista called BootSkin. And this is a little bit of an older program. This was released, I want to say, somewhere in the mid-2000s. This is actually a piece of software that I used on a couple of my Windows XP and even some of my Windows Vista machines like over 10 years ago. It's been a while since I've used this piece of software, but what this software allows you to do is, as you can probably tell by the name, it allows you to skin and customize your Windows boot screen, add a little bit more personality to your system, and make your boot screen look more unique. So, you know, it's going to be much different than everybody else's, which just says Windows XP when it boots up. And this is made by a company called Stardock, and I've used a couple of different Stardock programs before. There's another one of my favorite programs from them called Logon Studio. They provide a lot of customization tools for Windows. They have a whole pack called Object Desktop, I believe. They even make some games as well, but I have a feeling that we'll be covering some more Stardock software in the future on this channel if this video goes over well, and if you guys want to see more of that. So be sure to let me know if you guys enjoyed this video and want to see more like it down in the comments below. Now, I should mention that BootSkin is no longer supported. Both the XP and Vista versions have been out of support for a while now. I believe that the Vista version used to cost money. I want to say it was like $20 or $30, but they have now made both of these pieces of software totally free. And if you head on over to stardock.com/products/BootSkin, you'll be presented with this page right here. I'm going to have the link down below in this video's description if you want to go ahead and check it out. And all you have to do is just click on download and choose either the Vista or the XP version. And what I like about this program is it just makes it incredibly easy to change your boot screen on Windows XP or Windows Vista. You don't have to manually modify any files. So we're going to be taking a look at the XP version in today's video, but I may do a future video on the Vista version if you guys want to see that. But once you download the file, we're just going to go ahead and install the program here. So it downloads bootskinfree.exe. We're just going to run this here, and it's going to pop up with the installation wizard. So we're going to just install it to the default folder. We're going to click next. It's going to go through its automated install process, and we're just going to actually click on launch BootSkin and finish. And this right here is the interface for the entire program. Like I said, it's super, super simple to use. And we also have some custom boot screens already added in here for us that we can choose. We have one that is themed around the BOS. We've got a BootSkin themed boot, a Stardock boot. We also have an OS2 warp boot screen, which is pretty neat. And also something called a Tune boot. And if you don't like any of these ones that are in here, or if you just want to browse some other boot skins that other people have created, all you have to do is browse the boot skin library, and it will take you to this site called wincustomize.com. Now, apparently the link in the boot skin program itself is broken, but if you go back to the Stardock boot skin website and click on Get XP Boot Skins up here at the top of the screen, it will take you to this page, which actually shows you some of the skins that are available for download. And you can see that some of these are actually, I mean, they're not super recent, but I mean, this one was created towards the end of 2015, so that's really not that long ago, you know, considering that this program is from the mid-2000s. So you see that we even have some based around Windows 8. There's an Angry Birds one. There's a Winter Sunrise, Winter Impression. This is kind of like a DeviantArt-like website, but it's specifically for Stardock software. So, you know, we can do like a search if we want to. So let's say that we want to search for like a macOS boot skin. We can just do a search for that here. And these are all of the XP boot skins that are themed around macOS. So let's say that we want to get this one right here, which looks pretty funny. It's like a Sad Finder logo with Windows XP. It's called Not macOS. Let's go ahead and download this one here. This one was uploaded May 31st, 2007 by Patrol 52, and all we have to do is just click download. And it's going to download this file right here, and you want to open it with Stardock BootSkin. Yeah, and there it is right here, Mac Boot Color. So let's go ahead and actually try out one of these BootSkins. So let's go to this Mac boot color, and what you can do is actually preview the skin before that you apply it. So if we hit preview here, it will show you what the boot screen will look like when it is booting up your system. So it even has like the animation here. See, it says probably crashing. And all you have to do to get back to the main interface is just click anywhere and it will go away. So we can preview this Stardock one if we want to. Some of them don't have any like animation. So this one here is a good example of that. It's just a static image. So there won't be like any animation. I personally didn't really like skins like this. I wanted to find one that had like an animation. But if you wanted to give your computer kind of like an old vintage feel and use like this OS2 Warp one, you could use this one here. This Tune Boot is a animation one. This is kind of themed around the Win customized avatar up here. So that's you know, what this one is themed around. The BOS boot screen, this one also doesn't have any sort of animation, but again, if you want to give your system a little bit of a vintage or old OS, or I mean, BOS is kind of a obscure OS. I'm sure a lot of you haven't even heard of BOS. That, honestly, I could do a whole video on BOS. It was a very, very interesting and unique OS when it came out, and it was a very short-lived project as well. And you can, of course, just apply, if you ever want to go back to the old XP boot skin, you can do that from this program as well. So let's actually apply this Mac boot color skin. So we're just going to click on it, hit apply, and it's going to say boot screen applied successfully. This skin will be used the next time this machine is booted. So now what we want to do is just exit out of boot skin and hit turn off computer, and we're just going to restart, and I'm just going to show you guys how that this machine looks when it's booting up now. So here we go. It says Windows XP probably crashing with that sad finder face, and this is it. This is your XP boot screen. It will literally just, you know, show this until that's done with the boot up phase, and then we'll go right, you know, onto the login screen and onto the desktop. So that is it, guys. I mean, like I said, it's super, super simple to use. You don't have to modify any system files or anything like that, which is one thing that I really liked about this program. It was a very, very easy solution for me at the time, and it still is, as you can see. Now, Stardock does have a lot of other useful tools, like I said. One of them, another one of my favorite programs from them, is called Logon Studio. And Logon Studio is basically just like BootSkin, but for logon screens, and they also have a version for XP and Vista as well. Now, they don't actually really create, as far as I know at least, let's just go and check out their software here. I don't believe they have a version of BootSkin or Logon Studio for any like newer version of Windows. So like 7 and above, I don't think that they have a version for those newer OSs. But you see that they have a lot of software here. They also have this Object Desktop package, which is basically all of their software in one package. It costs $30. I definitely would like to take a look at this in a future video, so if you guys want to see that, be sure to let me know. But they just have a lot of really cool software. I've used Cursor FX before. I've used Fences was one of them. Let's see, Fences I think is up here at the top. Fences I used to use a lot on my computer. Let's see, they have Windows 8 applications. I think it's under, yeah, Stardock Classics. So this is where that you have BootSkin and Logon Studio. They also have this program, which allows you to make your own right-click menus, which is super cool. Also, something that is super cool is you can actually create your own BootSkins and Logon screens if you want to use Logon Studio. They actually have a guide here, I believe, if you go to BootSkin tutorial here. They have a guide showing you how to actually make your own BootSkins. Now, this does require having a photo editing tool like Photoshop. You might be able to get away with like MS Paint if you want to make like a really, really basic boot screen. But this is a like guide here that just tells you how to do it. And if you do it correctly, you can actually have BootSkin open up the file. And yeah, all that you have to do is when you actually create your BootSkin, if you do it manually, you can just go to File and Import from File and search for that .bootskin file that you have made. And that's how easy that it is. They also have a tool called Skin Studio, which is normally used to create visual styles for 7, Vista, and XP. But I believe that you can use this program as well, at least according to this guide here, to make BootSkins for XP. So, like I said, there's a lot of potential future videos that I can do on this company's software, and I really don't mind, you know, doing them because I have used this software myself. I mean, I'm not being paid by Stardock or sponsored by them. I mean, if you want to sponsor me, Stardock, go ahead, because I'd be happy to, because I like a lot of their software. But for today's video, guys, that is pretty much going to wrap it up. Again, just a very quick look at a awesome program for Windows XP. This is a great piece of software if you have like an older Windows XP computer that you want to keep using, or just use, you know, like for old gaming, stuff like that, and you just kind of want to make it your own, add a little bit of personalization, you know, customization to it. This is a very, very awesome way of doing that. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, definitely be sure to give it a thumbs up, be sure to get subscribed down below, and turn on channel notifications if you haven't already to get notified whenever that I upload new videos, which I do every single week on this channel. As always, guys, if you have any thoughts, any questions, any comments, be sure to leave them down below in the comment section. I always enjoy reading what you guys have to say. And as always, I just want to thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.